Welcome, Dr. P. Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, everyone.
Yeah, so we just wait for about 2 minutes. And, okay, I think we have a good strength and we can begin. So Dr. Bose, if you can start, by giving us a background, your background as well, and then just segue into whatever you would like to teach us today.
Yeah, so hello, everyone. I am Chandan, and I have graduated by doing my master's and PhD from IIT Madras in 2019. And after that, I have joined as a postdoctoral associate in the University of Liège, Belgium. So I would be talking about the basics of object-oriented programming for OpenFOAM. This is a general disclaimer that this offering is not endorsed by any of the official trademarks of OpenFOAM. Before I start this, I should acknowledge all the efforts of the OpenFOAM community that has been continuously increasing and enhancing our knowledge about this open source library. So I would thank all the committee members who are actually effortlessly working on the documentation part. And you guys, as learners, you know that how important the documentation and tutorials of this open source software are. Otherwise, we are completely in dark. So I'm actually honored to be a part of this committee and to help the community. Let us go ahead and let me show you what would be the outline of today's lecture. Okay, so I think, and as Dr. Janani has informed me, you already know this, how an OpenFOAM case is constructed and what are the different components of a particular case is, but I will just give you a quick recap and so that you can understand in what way we are going towards the source code, basically. After that, I will just jump into the object-oriented part of the OpenFOAM source code. So what are the different components of the object-oriented programming language C++ that is inherent in OpenFOAM to know? Those are consisting of space and time, field, boundary condition, matrices, and others, as we will see in a while. And then I will talk briefly about input-output object and the object registry, because those are very important, although boring part of this lecture, but you should really know what those are to know better the source code. And then I will show you how to write a hello world code from OpenFOAM background and how to compile it separately in your own user direct. So at the end, as time permits, and depending on the time, I will also customize this part in what detail I can go. Yeah, so before I go into the complete content of the lecture, I would just again remind you that you can stop me anywhere you want. You don't have to wait for the end of the lecture, because I think this is a kind of tutorial lecture where you should understand the things at that point of time itself. Otherwise, the upcoming things will be very much difficult to understand. Since I do not see you, any of you, in fact, so please feel free to stop and ask questions. I will be happy to clarify your doubts. I think all of you know that OpenFOAM, the abbreviation comes from Open Field of Operations and Manipulation. This is just a set of open source libraries for solving continuum mechanics problem. And this is under GNU public license, as you might know, even without knowing the implications of it, but it's free to use. So it is written in C++ programming language, and that's why we are here today, to know what are the different parts and components of the object-oriented programming that is included in OpenFOAM, in very basics, I would say. And lastly, this whole code or the library is written in finite volume method. Okay, so let us go ahead. So how OpenFOAM came into existence? So basically, the main softwares of OpenFOAM came into existence from the thesis work of Professor Jesek. Okay, so it started from 1989 at Imperial College London. And so after that, in 2004, it was actually adopted as a company and which decided to distribute the code as open source, which is OpenCFD Limited, which is still existent and main maintainer of this code. And then there are many companies that came into picture and tried to adopt with the workflow of this code. And as the time passed, the code has become really a very big library where from every corner of the world, people are contributing. So in 2012, ESI Group has actually owned the OpenCFD part of the OpenFOAM, although there exist three forks of this OpenFOAM source code. I will come in a while. But the main maintainer, if you know that the OpenFOAM.com version of this source code is owned by OpenCFD and ESI Group. So as I said, there are three forks for this OpenFOAM code. One is the OpenFOAM Foundation release, which you can find the source code as www.openfoam.org. And you might know that these OpenFOAM versions are released in every year as number, like starting from 2, 3, 4, and the recent version is version 8. And the other version is OpenFOAM OpenCFD version, ESI OpenCFD version, which is available in www.openfoam.com. And you might know that the recent version is OpenFOAM version 2012, which is basically representative of the 2020 and 12 month. That is, that means that it has been released in 2020 December. So just 1 month back. And just to let you know that there is a webinar coming from OpenFOAM about the new features of it. If any of you are interested, you can actually register for that. So the other one is Foam Extend, which is basically a community-driven development branch. And I have done my whole PhD based on Foam Extend, and which is available in the openfoamwiki.net. And the recent version is Foam Extend 4.1. These are the three forks you should know, because this is always a matter of confusion in people that which version should I use. Whether should I use version 8 or version 2012, and what are the differences? So from my end, I would say that version 8 and version 2012, that is the .com and .org versions, goes in line parallelly. So the development happens almost in line with each other. So you would find all the features available in both of these branches. And I personally use both of them. However, Foam Extend is a bit off track. So it has lot of new features and branches which are not available till now in OpenFOAM version 8 or version 2012. Like one of them is immerse boundary method, if some of you are interested. So if you really want to use such versions or such capabilities of OpenFOAM, you should actually go and use Foam Extend. Let's see if you guys are awake. So can you tell me which version if you guys are using for this course and assignments?
Currently we are using Foundation version, version 7.
Okay, so everybody in the class or somebody is using .com version also?
Sir, I am using .com version.
Which version?
Sir, 2012.
Yes. Okay, anybody is using Foam Extend? No, I guess. Yeah, because I thought so, because not many people know about it, because it's a community driven project and not much of documentation available. But I just wanted to share the information that this also has some extra capabilities which are not available in the .org version or .com version. Okay, fine. So another information that I wanted to share is that OpenFOAM has released as an initiative from the Documentation and Tutorial Committee, an OpenFOAM journal, which is open for submission for your information. And I am very proud to say that, you know, the upper picture is, you can see this topmost picture is the first simulation figure by Professor Jasek that was done using OpenFOAM. And the below figure is one of the figures which represents the chaotic flow dynamics of a flapping wing, comes from my PhD thesis. So both of these will be collaged as the cover picture of OpenFOAM journal first issue. So it's a matter of pride that my result is getting featured with Professor Jasek's first results of OpenFOAM. So I would really encourage you guys to work hard and do some development work and submit in this OpenFOAM journal in near future. So quickly, why to use OpenFOAM? As I So one, as I already said, that it is a community driven project and it's open source. So you do not have to pay lakhs of rupees for the license. Even if you open a startup company of CFD and try to serve different community needs on industrial basis, you can take open form, you can buy a good end computer and you can start your own company. You don't really need to buy license of commercial softwares by lakhs of rupees. Okay, the second point is high level programming. So you really do not need to do programming from very scratch level, because OpenFOAM has already inbuilt modules and inbuilt function for most of the CFD capabilities. So you can just take one of them and then use in your own code. You don't have to write. Let's say you want to solve a gradient or divergence. You don't have to write the code from scratch. You can just use the existing function object of OpenFOAM and write a code based on it, or write a solver based on it. So, and also you can take an existing solver of OpenFOAM, which I'll show you and demonstrate today, and then tailor it according to your need. You can include extra capabilities if you understand the code well. And that means that you are really not reinventing the wheel. Okay, and you are basically standing on the shoulder of the giants. So you have the solvers, you know your extra need, and then you can implement that and you serve to the community and other people can come and use that solver also. And it has really extensive capabilities for multi-physics coupled problems. If somebody, some of you are interested in coupling thermodynamics with flow physics, if somebody is interested in fluid structure interaction, or you want to see the effect of magnetism, then you can do it very easily, because each of these are separately, these capabilities are available in OpenFOAM. What we need to do is that we have to develop a coupler based on coupling algorithms and then bring all these capabilities together. So that's actually a very interesting part of OpenFOAM, which are very stringent and I would say very difficult and works as a black box in case of commercial softwares. Yeah, as I said, the cross platform coupling are also possible. And by high level programming, what I mean is, this is an example and very often given in the context of OpenFOAM. So you can see on the left hand side, the transport equation, okay, where there is a scalar and it's a scalar phi, and then you have a momentum equation of the velocity. And in the right hand side, you can see in these few lines, you can actually incorporate this whole partial differential equation, right? So here ddt is such a written in such a friendly language. Ddt is, you can understand, it's a time derivative. Div is divergence, Laplacian is Laplacian, grad is gradient. So, and I will come, what is FVC and FVM in a while. So what the point is that with this couple of lines of code, you can actually write a full momentum equation in the code. So you really do not have to worry about how to calculate divergence, how to calculate Laplacian, how to calculate gradient separately. So that's the beauty of this open source softwares. And this is a brief comparison with other commercial softwares, like cost effectiveness, I told. Parallel computing is a huge advantage of OpenFOAM, and for your information, there is a project coming up called ExaFOAM, where people will use millions of processors to reduce the computation time and solve very challenging problems in the fluid mechanics. So the source code is available to you, as we'll go through in a while. And then redistribution of the code is possible. That means that you contribute to the development of a code and that becomes the property of the community, and the community can use it and develop it on that. And it actually gives a huge scope for collaborative works. And as I told, the two shortcomings may be the documentation part, where the committee members are trying hard to make it up to date, and it's also hugely time taken. So a lot of more people needs to come forward and do this. And the other thing is, yes, you do not have the GUI, so-called graphical user interface, as such till today. But that also gives you liberty to learn the power of command line interface and write your own code, modify it, and get accustomed to that black screen, right? Okay. And these are 4 points from my side, what you should not expect from OpenFOAM. It's no black magic, okay? So you cannot just click it and get your output. There is no single executable, no native GUI, and it's not well documented, as I already told. All right, so let's see what is the simulation workflow in general. I think by doing some of these lectures already and doing some homework, you already know that for a CFD simulation, you have to first create a geometry of your interest. Then you have to discretize the geometry and create a mesh. And then you need a solver, basically, which is a piece of code which solves the governing equations, and which is the most challenging part of this workflow. That's why it may need some co-processing. That means you might have to go for parallel computing and so on. And then when you solve the equation, you have some results, you have to represent it, and you need to do some kind of post-processing to get your outputs, right? So in terms of OpenFOAM, what are these tools? So just to give you an idea about these three parts, pre-processing, solution, and post-processing. So in pre-processing in OpenFOAM, you already know you have block mesh, which is a great tool for meshing simple geometries. But then if you have a very complicated geometry, let's say you want to simulate the coughing of a COVID patient in 3D. So then you have a human face in the mesh as geometry, which is so complicated. Or let's say I give you another example, which I'm currently work on, is basically the nasal airflow. So when you inhale air and droplets, how the flow dynamics affects in your nasal air tract. So if you want to simulate that, you can imagine the human anatomy or animal anatomy, they are so complicated that you cannot really use block mesh. Okay, so you have to go for advanced tools. So Snappy Hex Mesh is one of them. And there are other, this orange region here is the open source alternatives. So I would say that these two, GMSH and Salome, are very powerful tools, and they are open source and they're free. So you can use it and try to explore their capabilities. And also you have some commercial options as such ANSYS Fluent Meshing, and then you can do it in SolidWorks for preparing geometry, and a good alternative of SolidWorks will be Blender, which is open source and has very nice capabilities. So coming to the solution part, OpenFOAM has all these different capabilities, as I said, incompressible flows, compressible flows, multiphase flows, combustion, heat transfer, molecular dynamics, electromagnetics, and as well solid mechanics. And then if you come to post-processing, you have ParaView as the main post-processing engine for OpenFOAM, I would say. And Salome also can be used to some extent, but I would suggest ParaView, and you all know ParaView is very good. And the commercial part is, I would suggest that the best would be Takeplot. And here I have written. So the another very powerful post-processing engine is Vizit. So if you have not tried, you should try it. So ParaView and Vizit are very good alternatives for commercial post-processing tools like Takeplot, which has the equal capability, and you should explore that. So let me ask you guys a question. So among this pre-processing, solution, and post-processing, which tools have you used till now?
We used ParaView and for solver. We have used ParaView
for post-processing and for pre-processing, yeah. The geometry and meshing.
We have mostly used block mesh only.
Okay, good. Okay, and what are the solvers have you used till now?
Incompressible.
So IcoFOAM.
Yeah. IcoFOAM, SimpleFOAM, and PimpleFOAM.
So let us now quickly recap whatever you have already learned, I think. So this is the basic structure of the OpenFOAM directory. So I will show you what these words mean. But anybody have any idea what is WM Project DIR is?
Directory.
But in total, this keyword WM underscore project underscore DIR. So what, which folder is this?
I think it is where open form files are stored, the source code and all the other stuff.
I think it's a installation directory.
Yes, true. I mean, you should at least guess it from the contents. So basically, this is the installation directory. So after, once you install the OpenFOAM version, any version you install, within the OpenFOAM, you will have a directory called OpenFOAM with some version. So let us see what are the different components of the main installation folder of OpenFOAM. So basically, it has a folder called applications, which is very important because which has all the solvers. Okay, so whatever solver OpenFOAM has are organized within this application folder and solvers folder. And then it has some test and utility folder. Basically, OpenFOAM codes can be basically divided into two parts. One is solvers, that means the source code of all the solvers. And then the other part is utility, which are some of the function object which complements this solver, right? So let me give an example. Let's say you are solving an incompressible Navier-Stokes equation, but then you want to calculate what is it, okay? So you need a code for that. So OpenFOAM has a function object for that. Or let's say you are calculating an external flow problem and you are calculating flow over a cylinder, and then you want to calculate the force, aerodynamic forces, lift and drag. So for that, you need a code, right? Other Navier-Stokes solver is actually giving you the field variables of like pressure and velocities. From that, you need to calculate the force. So for that, you need a function object to calculate the force. So those are part of these utilities. And then you have a tutorial folder, which you obviously have already explored. Then you have a SRC folder, where you have all the other source code, other than solvers and utilities. And then you have a bin, which has the installation files. And then you have doc, which has the user guide and programmer's guide. And then you have etc folder. We will go to it. And then platform is not very important. It also has some installation files. And WMake gives you the platform, or I would say it's a tool which allows you to compile the source codes of OpenFOAM or your own source codes, okay? So it is equivalent to CMake. So if some of you are aware of CMake, it's a tool which gives you a standardized installation and compilation procedures of C, C++ codes. So WMake is another tool which allows you to compile the source code of the OpenFOAM. Okay, so I think I will show this in my terminal.